Hello friends and welcome to Digimento. Today we will be discussing about economically weaker section quota. So recently this was again in the news and for many reasons this was being discussed deliberately these days because of the cutoff of various examinations depending upon the economically weaker section quota. So today we will be discussing about the economically weaker section quota and what it is, who are eligible for availing the benefits under this quota, and what is the reason and the rationale behind introducing such a quota by the government. So these are the topics that we will be discussing today. So let's begin. And if you have not yet subscribed to our channel UGC NTN at Computer Science, you can subscribe to our channel and also please do press the bell icon for receiving the notifications. And if you like this video, please do share it with your friends also. If you are preparing for GATE, NTA, UGC NET or PGT Computer Science, you can avail our online courses. And the details are available at our website www.digimento.com, or you can call to this number for getting more details about the same. So let's start. Central government has introduced this 10% reservation quota. So EWS quota, it is a reservation quota. We know that there are already various types of reservations existing. Like for example, we have the OBC reservation, which is for the other backward classes, so other backward classes. Then we have the SC scheduled caste, and we have the ST, that is the scheduled tribes. So for all these we have the quotas and the reservations. Now the central government has introduced the new set of reservations 1 year back, which is called the EWS reservation. So 10%, so this is the percentage of reservation available for the candidates under the EWS quota. So 10% quota will be available for the economically weaker sections among the general category candidates. Now we know that the OBC, the SC and the ST quotas, all these are based on certain social parameters. That is, the social backwardness is considered for giving these type of quotas. Social backwardness means maybe in the past their community has been socially backward, and because of that they are facing some kind of difficulties to come to the mainstream, whether it is education or the government jobs. So OBC, SC and ST quotas, these are available on the basis of social backwardness. Now the government wants to give reservation to the economically backward sections. So those people who are economically backward but belongs to the general category. So general category means the forward class. So general category refers to those caste or class which belong to the forward caste or forward class, we can say. Okay. So those candidates from the forward class, but those who are economically weak, that means their financial credentials are not good. So economically weaker sections within the forward class will be eligible for this 10% of reservation, and this will be available for government jobs and in educational institutions. So in government jobs, 10% of the jobs will be reserved for the EWS category, economically weaker section, that is the forward class. And among this forward class, the economically weaker section. And in the educational institutions as well, 10% of the seats will be reserved for the economically weaker class or the sessions. Now, this is introduced by a constitutional amendment bill which was passed in the parliament, and then finally the president had given the assent to it. So, it is the 103rd Constitutional Amendment Act. Now, when a constitutional amendment is proposed in the parliament through the way of a bill, it is called the amendment bill. So, a bill has to be passed. So, this is an amendment bill, and it was the 124th Constitutional Amendment Bill. And once this bill is passed in the parliament and president gives the assent to it, then it becomes Constitutional Amendment Act. So, we have the 103rd Constitutional Amendment Act. I will also explain what is a Constitutional Amendment Act. So, the EWS, economically weaker sections. So EWS has been introduced through the Constitutional Amendment Bill, and once this bill was passed in the parliament and president had given his consent for the bill, it has become a Constitutional Amendment Act. It is the 103rd Constitutional Amendment Act 103. And why we call it as a constitutional amendment act? This is because when various proposals are made by the parliament in the form of bill in the parliament to amend the constitution, that is to make amendments to the provisions of the constitution, it is called a constitutional amendment bill. And once this bill is passed, it is called a Constitutional Amendment Act. Why? Because certain provisions of the constitution are now altered or changed. Okay. Now we will see in case of the 103rd Constitutional Amendment Act, which are the constitutional provisions that are changed. Article 15 and Article 16 of the Constitution, which are included under the fundamental rights. So Article 15 and 16, which are included under the fundamental rights in the Constitution, are now changed. Now let's come to the background of this issue. So first of all, the most important Supreme Court judgment regarding the reservation is the Indira Sawhney case of 1992, a very, very important and a landmark judgment given by the Supreme Court. So a backward class cannot be determined only and exclusively with reference to economic criteria. So this was one of the observations made by the Supreme Court in the Indira Sawhney case. So here the Supreme Court clarified that the backwardness of a community cannot be solely determined upon the economic condition of that community. And 50% quota as the rule, unless extraordinary situations inherent in the great diversity of this country and people happen. So this was a second observation made by the Supreme Court, that the overall reservations cannot be more than 50%. So suppose there are 100 vacancies for a particular post, not more than 50 posts can be reserved for the backward classes. So this was a second important observation made by Supreme Court in the Indira Sawhney case. So 50% is the maximum quota that the government or the reservations can provide, unless in extraordinary situations. Now we also have another commission's report, that is Sinha Commission's report of 2010. So Sinha Commission report never explicitly recommended a reservation for economically weaker session, and it asserted that economically weaker sessions can be identified by states for extending the welfare measures only. So this was the recommendation given by Sinha Commission. So Sinha Commission in 2010 also said that we cannot exclusively make a reservation for economically backward sessions within a forward community. So reservations should be made on the basis of social backwardness, not on the basis of economic backwardness. And also it said that the state governments, that is the states, can take up certain welfare measures for the economically backward, not reservation. Reservation is not a solution for the economic backwardness. Now this is the total reservations that we have in our country now. So here we will see that scheduled caste have 15% reservations, and scheduled tribes have 7.5% reservation, OBCs 27%. Now the EWS, economically weaker section, has a 10% reservation. So altogether we will see that about 60% of the total vacancies or the total seats in either jobs or educational institutions are reserved. So it is a clear violation of the Supreme Court observation made in the Indira Sawhney case. And upon merit, only 40.5%, that is general merit, 40.5% seats are only reserved under the general merit. So this is the present situation after the introduction of the EWS. Okay, so I hope you get the point here. Now we will also see what are the eligibility criteria for EWS. So first one, it is only for general category candidates, which means that this quota, economically weaker section quota, this is applicable to forward communities and economically weaker sections within the forward community. The criteria is that the family gross annual income should be less than 8 lakh rupees. So family's gross annual income, gross annual income means without deducting the taxes, should be less than 8 lakh. Family should not own or possess agricultural land size of more than 5 acres. So agricultural land should be less than 5 acres. Family should not own or possess a residential flat area of 1000 square feet, which means that if you have a house or a residential apartment of more than 1000 square feet, you are not eligible for this quota. Family should not own or possess a residential plot area of 100 yards or more in notified municipalities. Why? Because in municipalities, the value of land is more than that of rural areas or agricultural land. So, in case of municipalities, the family should not possess a residential plot of area of 100 square yards. Now, let's come to the difference between EWS and the OBC. So, 27% of reservation is provided to OBCs, non-creamy layer. So, non-creamy layer means economically backward OBCs. So, non-creamy layer candidates among the other backward communities are provided with a 27% reservation. 10% is allowed for economically weaker sections among the general category candidates. So, the quota is different in case of OBC. It is 27%, whereas EWS quota is only 10%. No relaxations regarding age limit or number of attempts granted for economically weaker candidates. So, when you are appearing for an examination, you will see that in case of OBC, ST and SC, you will have some relaxations with regard to your age limit or the number of attempts. But in case of EWS, there is no such relaxations with regard to age limit or the number of attempts. But relaxations in age limit, number of chances, cutoffs, etc. are available for OBC, SC and the ST. Now, income of the OBC candidates. Income of the candidate or his spouse is not included. Okay, in case of OBC, the person's own income or the income of the spouse is not included under OBC. Whereas in the definition of EWS quota, the income of the family is taken, which includes the income of the candidate as well as the income of the spouse of the candidate. So, these are some of the differences between both of this. Now, irrespective of your category, whether you are general, OBC, ST or SC, the new quota will change the accessible seat share, that is 10% fewer jobs. Now, suppose there are 1000 vacancies. Now, before EWS, 580 seats will be given or SC. Now, what happens? It will be reduced to 480. So, in each category, you will see here that this is 10,000. So, So here you will see that in each category after the introduction of EWS, the seats, number of seats will come down. So, there is a small mistake in this PPT. I'm sorry for that. But generally what needs to be understood is that, before the introduction of EWS, each category will have more number. But now because 10% is, suppose there were 100 seats earlier. Now, we will take this example. So, 100 seats earlier. So, now, there is only 90. Why? 10 is given to EWS. And from this 90 only, the others will have to share. Okay. So, this is the general thing about the EWS and the difference between EWS, OBC, etc. So, this was one topic that many students had asked me to make a lecture on. I hope you like this video and please do share it with your friends if you have liked it. Thank you so much.